So why did you decide to found a startup from your research project?
So I myself, I worked in startups before starting my PhD, and I liked the atmosphere. I liked how much impact you have on the product, because I also had experience from large industry, and I saw how small of a piece I am in a big machine. So I was always thinking of either working for a startup or making my own startup. And then I didn't really have an idea, so I said I will do research in a group, in a research group where a lot of people start startups and potentially something good might turn out. And then I started doing that, and I somehow even forgot about the startup. I was motivated by the science behind it. But then at some point, we said, okay, we have to file a patent application based on what we are doing. And then you start thinking, when you meet your patent attorneys, they start questioning you. So what industry should we cover? What markets are there? What are the competitor solutions? And that forces you a bit to think about the business. And then Michela was there, also very entrepreneurial, motivated to move forward. And then after we submitted the patent application, we also started participating in some competitions. And after the first successes in the competitions, we had really positive feedback. We also found that there are a couple of companies interested in our product, and that's how we slowly started, without really forcing it, but we started, we got the first projects, and we had to hire our first engineers to help us develop a product, and yeah, now it's slowly growing. Maybe a bit slower than what we planned and what we expected, but it's, I think, almost always the case.